Welcome to Studio 1430, a Norwegian talk show filled with stars from the underground. Real music, real people, and real stories. Enjoy the cult!
We're the opening band for the entire festival, and, well, so many hands in the air. Yeah, just wow.
Hello, today we are here with the band Hiddens from Bergen in Norway. Hello guys.
Hey man.
Can you please introduce yourself and your role in the band?
Yes, I'm Fredrik. I do the vocals and the guitars, and I'm one of the founders of the band.
Hello, my name is Tore, and I play the guitar. I'm also one of the founders.
Yeah, my name is William, and I play the bass guitar for the band.
You play the bass guitar. Yeah. Okay, can you say something about the start, the beginning of Hiddens?
Yes, it all started out when me and Tore got invited to Hellish Outcast to have a pre-listen to their debut album in 2010, and we was talking about lyrical themes and music and how music life was, and from the lyrics Hiddens popped out, and we started a band called Hiddens.
But they play a different kind of music than Hiddens. Why did you go more into the black metal sound?
First, we started off as a Lamb of God cover band. And then Frederick decided...
Let's go black and never go back.
Great. Okay, you got a new album out. Can you say something about it? And like, why was it so much delayed?
Well, we kind of had a couple of difficulties with some band members, and we also didn't have the founding when it finally got time to record an album. And when we did have the founds, I broke my wrist, and it got postponed because we didn't have a guitarist at that point to step in. And then, a year later, when it was time again, I broke my other wrist. Yeah. And it got delayed, and then it got really much delayed. And Henrik Skar from Winterbris wanted to step in. And then we could finally record the album after 5 years.
Yeah, so on the album, Henrik Skar is playing the guitar, or your guitar.
Yes.
And Tore Henrik is playing the other guitar.
Yeah,
of course. Yeah. Okay. The album got one song in Norwegian. Why is that?
I usually write the lyrics, or Frederik writes some of them, but I try to write. I decided I wanted to write in Norwegian because I haven't done that before, and I usually write English lyrics.
So, how do you write the lyrics?
Try to come up with a story and take it from there.
Yeah, a story. So what are the songs about? Is there stories in every song?
Sometimes myths or... Yeah. All the... folk tales or something like that.
Yeah, cool. Great. Is there any, by the way, is there any place where we can read the lyrics in a booklet or on
not
the internet?
Yet.
Not yet. But they will come.
Maybe.
Maybe you don't want to share it.
Maybe we are taking
the Gorlov way.
Yeah.
You shouldn't ask the wrong questions. You shouldn't ask the wrong questions.
Okay.
Yes.
True. Okay, men yeah. Where did you record, mix and master the album?
We recorded the album in this room, which is possessed by Satan.
Yeah, but this is your rehearsal space. Yeah.
This is, and yeah, so we recorded the drums and guitar and the vocals here. And William did the bass at home.
Yeah. I thought it was just the same. I could just do it at home. It was much simpler than going in here and start plugging myself in with my own computer and stuff. So I just did it at home. Didn't have to move anything. Easy peasy.
Yeah. So it was, to be more productive or to make it faster.
Yeah, and he didn't need to record from the cabinet of the bass.
Yeah, so we just wanted to make it more quick going, the process, just making go as quick as possible. So we just tried to do everything we could at home or here. So we had everything set up for a little while before we started recording, and we just kept it that way for a little while.
Clever. But who did mix and master the album?
Herwan Larsen and Arve Isdal and Bjørnar Erevik. From Conclave and Earshot Studios in Bergen.
All right.
They mixed it and mastered it.
Yeah. Awesome guys.
Yeah, and you got a big, heavy, loud, awesome sound on it. So
thank you.
Because of you guys and because of them.
Yeah.
Okay, the artwork. How do you make the artwork for the album? Or who make it?
In 2013, I decided to ask a guy who did the tribute artwork for Enslaved, David Thier, over Facebook. And he answered me back that if I just send some songs and some lyrics, he can write or start making the artwork for the album.
Okay, great. So he made the artwork for this, for the Hayden's album.
Yes.
Great. Will you use the same guy on the next record?
Maybe.
That's
we'll see.
Too early to say.
Yeah.
Okay. How was it to open up at the Blastfest Festival now in February?
It was pretty cool. There was a lot of people, and a lot of people cheering for Satan.
Yeah. Not for us. We don't matter.
No, only
he does.
Only Satan.
Yeah.
Great.
But it was pretty cool actually, because we were the entire band and on stage. So many hands in the air. Yeah, just wow. It was awesome, really.
It's the first time we play for so many people at Garage.
It was packed with the crew, with the audience, with the
indeed.
It was packed with black.
Great one. Yes. Okay. So, yeah. Live, did Henrik play with you then?
Yes, he did play the guitar.
He played the guitar, and you only did the vocals.
Yes.
And I also know that you used some costumes.
Yeah, we did some medieval black monk robes.
Yeah.
To because on the artwork it has some guys or all the wise men going in some monk robes, and we decided to do since we played only the album at the festival, we decided we can just use robes to give them that kind of feel.
Yeah, it look great. Okay, what are Hayden's future plans? Or the next months?
We already started making new music. Yeah.
So we went to the rehearsal space here on Thursday. Well, we've had a couple of riffs and stuff, but that we've been trying to build up for the last half year, I think. So when we got to the rehearsal space on Thursday, now we almost completed producing a completely new song. So well, hopefully things are going to go more steady from here on out. Maybe we'll have a new album in short time.
Oh, great.
Maybe I'll not break anything.
No, hopefully you'll not break more arms. But how are the process of songwriting as you are meeting up here and playing riffs and jamming together?
Yeah, I usually try to make riffs at home and then bring them along here to jam on them and check if everybody likes them. And if they do, we use them.
Sometimes we just jam around in the rehearsal space and we found something really grim and make a song out of that sometimes.
So it's basically with a lot of other bands, we just randomly find something that we're jamming and then we use it, or somebody just finds something at home, just something pops into their head and we can use that. So it's basically with a lot of other bands, really. So, yeah.
Can you mention some albums, some specific albums you are inspired by? Or bands?
Bathory, Blood on Ice.
Yeah, a lot of Helheim and Tåke and
Bursum.
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 Drudk.
Sweet Norway and Is... Nej.
And Vinterbris.
Vinterbris.
Taking a lot of, when it comes to the bass at least, a lot of references from, especially Enslaved, because Grutli's got a really cool set of bass lines here and there, so I've been kind of inspired by especially Ritir and Axioma Etika Odini. Well, especially those two, they're amazing. And we also have, not say anything bad or good or anything, but the three first Metallica albums with Cliff Burton on there, well, he was a god.
He was.
Yeah, so I'm trying to snap something up from there too sometimes. Just trying to make a little more flow instead of just playing along with the guitar.
Yeah.
Make it a little more creative.
It's very cool that you like Enslaved that much, and you also you work with the guys from Enslaved. in studio.
Really nice guys.
Yeah, they're awesome.
We also have to mention Hellish Outcast, of course.
Yeah, of course.
Since we started because of them.
Yeah.
Their EP is their first EP is amazing, and that's where it all started.
Yeah, what's the name of that?
Raping, Killing, Murder.
Yeah.
Check it out.
It's so great. Yeah. Okay. Do you got something more you want to say to the audience?
Hail Satan.
Stay true.
Stay true and hail Satan.
Check out Vinterbris and Henrik Skar. He was a major part of the debut album and making that sounding better.
Yeah, better than it should have.
Yeah, that he added more depth to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, great. So
it was amazing.
Yeah, we should have the guy here.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much for your time.
And, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Maybe we'll have a new talk in some years or something.
Indeed.
Okay. Sounds like a plan.
Goodbye, guys.
Goodbye.
See you.